We're going to look at what the Langmuir isotherm would look like if we have dissociative adsorption of hydrogen, namely a hydrogen molecule approaches the surface, interacts, and dissociates into two hydrogen atoms that are adsorbed on the surface. So we have hydrogen from the gas phase and then two sites. So these are, for example, platinum atoms. And we end up with two hydrogen atoms, one atom on each site. This is reversible. If we want the Langmuir isotherm, we assume that we have adsorption equilibrium. Namely, we assume the rate of adsorption is the rate of desorption. Now, what's different from the typical Langmuir isotherm is this dissociative process. So if we write an adsorption equilibrium constant, the pressure of hydrogen, because that's the proportional number of collisions, then we need to put the fraction of vacant sites. So this is a fraction, and it's a fraction of sites that are vacant and therefore able to adsorb hydrogen atoms. And this is the rate of desorption, the fraction of sites that have hydrogen squared. So this is squared because it takes two hydrogen atoms recombining to make a hydrogen molecule. The fraction of vacant sites here is squared, because we need a vacant site, and then we need a vacant site next to that vacant site in order to adsorb a hydrogen molecule. And we're just going to rearrange this equation and write the ratio of the rate constants. We're going to call this an adsorption equilibrium constant. And then we're going to take the square root of both sides. So this is an adsorption equilibrium constant. The pressure of hydrogen to the 1/2 power, theta of vacant sites. This is equal to the theta of hydrogen. We're interested in what's the dependence of the fraction of sites with hydrogen as a function of hydrogen pressure. So we're going to use the fact that sites either have hydrogen or they're vacant. The fraction must add to 1. We'll make this substitution in the equation and then simplify. And so what we've done now is simplify it to end up with an expression that is the fraction of the sites on the platinum surface that are occupied by hydrogen atoms. Notice that low hydrogen pressures, namely when this term is small relative to 1, then the fraction is going to be proportional to the square root of the hydrogen pressure. And at high hydrogen pressures, where this term now is large relative to 1, theta H will approach 1. So then this looks like following. This is fractional coverage versus pressure. At low pressures, this proportional pressure of hydrogen 1/2. And then you can see we have to go to much higher pressures to get to saturation. At this pressure, we're about 0.65 of saturation. So it slowly approaches saturation as a function of hydrogen pressure.